was running a fraud. A classic pyramid scheme.
All right, well, why don't you tell us what you know?
He sent emails to investors at Smith Waterson that looked like official communication.
It's called spoofing.
Those emails claimed that he was connected to Smith Waterson, asked investors to send him information, user IDs, security codes, and such, so he could get into their accounts.
Now, why didn't people complain about missing money?
Mr. Riley was a very, very smart man. Instead of pulling out lump sums, which might draw immediate notice, he had a scheme to drain out of large sums without raising an alarm. He started by taking $2 out of each account. Then he'd replace the money within a few days by taking $2 more out of 2 more accounts. So he'd put $2 back and keep the other two for himself. He recorded them as accounting errors with amounts so small, no one double-checked.
Okay, so how does $2 become half a million?
Okay, good question. And I have folded this paper twice. It is now 4 times as thick as it was. If I could potentially fold it 50 times, how tall do you think the resulting stack of paper would be?
Well, I mean, it's got to be at least a couple feet.
No, I'd say more like a building.
Tall enough to reach the sun.
Wow.
It's a geometric progression. I mean, obviously, you cannot fold this paper 50 times. A high school student named Brittany Gallivan predicted a way to do it 12 times, and then she did it with actual paper. She set a world record.
How tall was it?
Foot and a half. The same principle applies to embezzlement. However, it takes twice as many accounts at each level. It's a pyramid scheme. You know, it can't last, but by the 19th progression, Riley had siphoned off $524,288.
Right, because he'd always need twice as much to replace what he'd taken.
You run out of resources. The pyramid collapses. And by the time it all crashes down, Riley's long gone.